Hello friends, welcome to TechDose, and in this lecture we will see what is logic programming and why should we even care about using logic programming. So the word logic simplifies everything, that it is based on logic. It will solve logical questions like which involve puzzles or relationships or objects. Okay, so we will see just by taking an example. Suppose we take a example, suppose John owns the book. Okay, so this is the sentence. So you can see here that the object is book, this is the object, okay, and this is the person, and the relationship between this person and object is that the person owns this object, so they are related by owns relationship. So this is called a relationship, and such type of relationship questions can be easily solved by using logic programming. And one of the logic programming which we will see in this tutorial is PROLOG. In logic programming, we have a knowledge base. Okay, we have a knowledge base. Knowledge base means whatever is known from our earlier experience and whatever we already know. And we provide the knowledge base with facts and some rules. And these are fed to the machine. And this machine takes this knowledge base and takes your question and then produces an answer, either yes or no, or either yes or no, or some other output. Okay, so this takes the knowledge base, takes your question, processes it, and then gives the answer in the form of yes or no or some other form as output. Okay, in our conventional language, you already know that in our conventional language, suppose C or C++ or Java, we don't use any knowledge base. You just have to include the libraries. First, you have to include all the libraries. Then you start your main function and then you declare some variable, suppose int a and something like that. And then you write down the procedures, how to calculate the output, and then finally print the output and then return. Yes, this was the process in our conventional programming languages, but coming to logic programming languages, it is completely different and it has no relation with C or C++ or Java. If you are familiar with C++ or Java, then you must be familiar with the object-oriented programming, and you know that in C++ and Java we use objects. So a problem is divided into different objects. These objects are all combined for a particular answer, for a particular solution. Okay, but in PROLOG we don't use object oriented programming. You might have heard me saying objects in PROLOG. So the objects in PROLOG are very different from that in C++ and Java. In C++ and Java, the object is a data structure. Object is a data structure that can inherit fields and executable methods from a class hierarchy to which the object belongs. That means the classes, that means in the C++ or Java, if you create an object, then it can also inherit all the variables and the methods or functions from its upper class, that is from its super class, if you are familiar with C++ or Java. If you are not familiar with C++ or Java, or not familiar with the object oriented programming languages, then you should skip this part. Now in PROLOG, object is very different from that in C++ and Java. I already told you the object in C++ and Java, and in PROLOG I already gave you this example: John owns the book. Okay, the book. Now here the object is book, and here the object is a data structure. So you can see that in PROLOG the objects are very close to the English meaning, while in C++ or Java object is typically a data structure. In PROLOG the objects does not refer to a data structure that can inherit variables and methods from a class. It refers to things that we can represent using terms. So book is a thing which we can represent using terms. And hold on, I will tell you about terms, facts, knowledge base and all these things in our next tutorial. Okay, so don't panic here. So coming back to our question of why we should use logic programming, I can tell you that in logic programming, if you are familiar with the software development cycle, then you must be knowing that the maintenance of a software is the most costly part of the software development, because the software development is not that difficult, but once the software has been developed, the maintenance of that software is the real challenge. Okay, and the most of the cost, around 60% of the cost of the software, is consumed in the maintenance process. Okay, so this maintenance actually determines the final cost of the software. In PROLOG or in the logic programming, example is PROLOG, the maintenance cost is drastically reduced, while in C++ or Java or other imperative or object-oriented languages, the cost is pretty high. So what is the reason behind it? In PROLOG, the readability of the code is very easy. So if you have, suppose if a person A has developed a software, so person B can easily read that software, understand it very easily, and then he can modify according to his wish. Then another person C can read his written software, and he can also change the software accordingly without any difficulty. But when you have written a code in C++ or Java, you might have seen that it is very difficult to understand the codes written by different developers. So the maintenance becomes very hard, and it becomes very costly process, because the number of developers, the number of maintenance people which will be needed will be very large as compared to when the program would have been more readable. So this is the cost factor is the main factor behind this, why we should use logic programming instead of that conventional programming languages. So this is only one of the field which I am talking about. I will later show you the applications of logic programming, but here only for the introductory part I have shown you why we should use logic programming at all. Other applications include distributed databases, air traffic control, multimedia, and so on and so forth. Okay, so we will see in our next lecture the introduction about PROLOG, and then we will move on to do questions on PROLOG. So stick to our channel to see all the PROLOG videos. Thank you.